This is the case of a 66-year-old female with a medical history of heartburn and functional dyspepsia. From March 2015 to January, she underwent 5 EGD with resection of recurrent duodenal bulb adenoma, high-grade dysplasia. On March, the VCE didn't show any pathological findings. Current problem, duodenal bulb EMR of recurrent adenoma. You see the lesion. Scheduled procedure, duodenal EMR. Learning objectives, understand duodenal EMR indications, discuss potential EMR limits and contraindications, and understand how to manage potential EMR complications. Let's pass the floor to the endoscopic room.
Okay, good afternoon. I have a pleasure to work here with Raf, of course, and Lucio.
Hello.
Just at the back, and he knows the patient perfectly. And so we are also working with Carla, just in front of me, and Adriana, who is taking care of the sedation. So, of course, this case is real endoscopy. The previous case, this was virtual endoscopy. Of course, I appreciate very much the Muse system, which is very effective, but it is more or less virtual.
It is.
And this one will be real. And I hope we will manage the complication because this is part of the goal of this procedure. So we just passed, as you recognize, the pylorus, and we are just in front of a lesion. So it has been told to you that this is a recurrent lesion, and the patient already had 5 attempts to resect. So this is the lesion, not easy to see, in fact, but nevertheless, we are using a Fujifilm endoscope from 600 series, so excellent quality, high definition endoscope, with a zoom, and you see the lesion here. And there on this endoscope, you have FICE, like this, and we better see the limit of the lesion, or here. I will come back probably to FICE 1, and then we have a zoom, like this, and we will see the lesion, yes, like this, okay? And you see the limit of the lesion are quite easy, and you see you have a small piece of adenomatous tissue, and you see the lesion. Okay, we can enlarge a little, but then it is more difficult to see the limits. I think we should stay in between, probably with a magnification of 50, and then here, it's a little more difficult to see the limit. Huh? Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, it looks normal, and then you see the lesion here. But the limits are more difficult to determine at the upper part of the lesion. It's easier here. Then, if you look carefully, and I go back without the zoom, you have all the lesion here. And this lesion looks a little different if you apply zoom. You see the lesions are a little different. It means this lesion, for me, are in antral metaplasia, located in the bulbus. And certainly, there are all of the lesions like this, antral metaplasia. Nothing to do. So these lesions are looking more or less like antral mucosa and less villous than this one, just, I will come back, just here. This one looks more villous, you see? And then we go back to regular imaging without zoom. I had a look also on the rest of the duodenum, and so I did not find any other lesions because always you have to have a look on the other lesions. By chance, we are just in front of a lesion using a forward viewing endoscope. Sometimes in the duodenum, it's better to use a lateral viewing as a duodenoscope, but in this case, we are perpendicular. This is the only problem. We are really nicely located, but just perpendicular. Now,
so
yes.
Would you mark here because the border at the upper side is not so clear. So
yes, but I think first of all we need maybe to use indigocarmine mm-hmm. and to see if we could better define the limit.
Yeah.
Okay. So I always use indigocarmine to define the limit of such lesion when you see the border is not enough precise enough. And I will use indigocarmine, I think it's 0.2, huh? Not yeah. too, it's quite diluted. never use enogarcamine too concentrated. So this is just a detail, but when I push the spray catheter, I always target not the lesion, mm-hmm. to avoid to damage the lesion, you see?
Yeah.
Because you never know, huh? So I push.
There's almost no scarring.
Yes. Okay, you see, when I push, I can target the So then I go, yes, this is what is, yes, you're right. It is a little surprising.
There's almost no scarring of the previous.
Now you can spray. So if you compare to the rest of the, if you compare the diameter of a lesion to the diameter of a.
Perhaps you should switch off the device mode.
Yes. If you, sorry, yes, it's my fault.
Yeah.
And then, you're right, but I'm so used to use NBI or FICE, but I'm always in with a FICE more than with a NBI.
Terry, do you think EMI is still possible, or would you think APC could be an option?
I will try EMR with a regular snare, but there was a discussion to use, yes, we better see the upper limit. Huh? Nevertheless, the lesion is a little heterogeneous. Huh?
It's really hard to delineate.
But at the upper part, it's okay now. Mm. Just in the middle, it looks quasi normal. Huh? Mm. I don't think we need to put some markings around. It will be maybe. I think we can succeed without markings. Okay. So now the discussion could be. Which technique we have to use? Initially, I was ready to use a transparent cap, okay, like this.
Yeah.
And the transparent cap by Haru Inoue, and we are using this cap for mucosal resection within the esophagus, but it's also helpful in the duodenum to resect, for example, submucosal tumor. Mm-hmm. And when you have a small submucosal tumor, I use this cap.
Perhaps it's important to emphasize, if you have a straight-on position like now, you better use a straight cap. So you don't use the oblique cap when you have a position like that. In the esophagus, we always use the oblique cap, but in the stomach, if it's a straight-on position like this, you need to use a straight cap.
Yes, you're right. But there are some risks related to the use of this cap, and the risk is clearly perforation. Mm. So if we don't need to use, I think it's better. And if we can use a classical method, it's better. Mm. Okay, but if the lifting is not satisfying, it's not perfect, if we are in trouble, maybe we could use the cap. But so far, I think we can try to lift the lesion and to see if we can resect the lesion as usual with a snare. And in this case, a snare master, flexible, from Olympus, 10 millimeter diameter. Okay? So but the only question could be to delineate the lesion before. And you see that.
Many of these small, tiny
but there are
changes.
Small, yes, but I'm quite surprised because there are plenty of all the lesions. Huh? Because you see, this is, and maybe, no, sorry, I want to come back to the Zoom. Yes. What is this? Difficult to say, huh?
It's very difficult, yeah, I agree.
Very difficult to determine. So for sure, this is intestinal, this is antral metaplasia. But
Terry,
this is more difficult.
There are two questions from the audience. The first one is, can you show the scar from the previous treatment?
No, I'm quite surprised also. I don't see the scar.
Okay.
But this patient has been already examined by Lucio, and Lucio, you are certain that this was the lesion initially, no?
That was on the picture.
No, this was referred by us to us by the hospital.
But you saw the case before?
Yeah, I found only this lesion.
But this lesion for sure is
yeah.
That's more villous, that part.
But this part, I'm a little less convinced. But nevertheless, we don't see a scar too. And you are sure that the lesion was located in the bulbus, huh?
Yeah.
Well, it happens quite often, I find, that you don't see the scar in the duodenum very well, even after rather extensive resections. It's sometimes difficult
to find. But five resections?
Yeah.
I'm surprised.
You would expect it. Yeah.
But the other question is, what kind of dilution is indigo carmine?
0.2.
Sorry?
0.2.
0.2.
Okay. Let's try to lift it.
Yes, we tried to lift, but nevertheless, I'm quite in doubt.
It's a difficult...
No, I'm quite in doubt, not to lift, but I'm not concerning the lesion itself. Huh? We were looking on the screen at the little trypsy, in fact.
Yeah, we saw you waiting, so...
Yeah, no, it's okay. So, in fact, we examined the rest of the duodenum. So there are several types of lesions. You have antral metaplasia, you have some hyperplasia, some Brunnerian hyperplasia, huh? And we call Brunneroma.
Yeah.
And the only lesion we saw clearly, and which looks like an adenoma, is this one. And why I'm so sure is also because you see the white whitish part in front of me, and you see this whitish part is usually at the periphery of adenoma. So I don't see other lesions. So it's very surprising that there is no scar. So I don't know exactly what this has been done before, but we will see if it can lift. So I delineate, by waiting for you, I delineate to be sure that we resect the whole lesion. So now we'll inject to see if we can lift adequately. We have a snare ready, which is the snare master. And of course, we have also clip ready in case we have perforation. And we have also quad grasper in case of bleeding. And we have also an ovescope clip, an ovescope clip in case of large perforation.
Yeah.
So we are ready for any complication, such as it has been presented in the, I think this was the third aim, to discuss how to manage complication. First, to manage complication, you should be ready, and you should have all accessories ready, and the nurses well-trained to use clip. So now we are inserting the needle. So needle out, okay, perfect. And I will not hesitate to inject in the middle, because, no, 1 minute. Yes. I go back, inject a little. Yes. No, it's not yet. I usually inject, I push, then I go back a little, inject. Inject, no, 1 minute. Inject. Does not lift so well. I can inject? Mm-hmm. How many did you inject?
One.
Yes.
Now it's coming, yeah.
Now it's coming, yes. Because I'm a little more superficial, yes, inject. You see, I'm very superficial. So we put some indigo carmine in the syringe. You can, yeah. You see, I push the needle, and then I pull on the needle just to be very superficial. And you see the lifting is now at the level of the dots. So it's quite good. You can continue a little.
So I think you show nicely here that is even the lifting is something you can control very
Yes.
You can direct where you want to lift
it
to go.
And I always tell my young co-workers, you have different levels in the submucosa. If you inject too deep, you have a very large lifting, but not very high. Mm. If you inject very superficially, you have a high lifting like this. Okay, it looks at least, yes, continue. So 4 cc. And the nurses, I asked the nurses. I asked the nurse, yes, it's enough maybe, okay. Yes, close. Yes, and gave me the snare.
Yeah, it's a nice lifting.
Nice lifting so far, but now the question is to know if we will take easily the lesion. So maybe 10 millimeters is a little small. We will see if we need to have a larger one, no?
Mm-hmm.
So I will apply the snare as yesterday. That means...
backhand?
Yes, like this. So I will apply the snare from the proximal part. Yes, you can. Okay. Now this is my foot. You can open slowly. Open slowly, yes. Open.
What type of snare
is it? Open. Push, open. No, don't...
This one is the thin one.
No, I need the 10 millimeter snare. I don't need the asymmetrical snare. So, okay. Because we prepare an asymmetrical snare for the cap.
Okay.
But I need a... No, this is my fault. I should have controlled which snare you gave me. So now this is the regular snare. You see, in between, the lesion is less lifted. But we will try nevertheless to take it. So I will push the snare from this part. Yes, oh, yes. One minute. You can open. Slowly, yeah? Open.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, slowly. Open slowly. So, yes, 1 minute. Open slowly. Open slowly. Yes, open. Yes, open. Yes, okay.
Yes, will be good.
Yes, it could be good. Now, I push like this, and I will suck.
Yeah.
I will suck. Yes. No, don't do anything.
No.
Wait for my order. Yes. Thank you. Now I will close. But if I close now, the risk is that I can lose the lesion. So you will close slowly, and I pull a little on the catheter. Close. I pull a little to reduce the pressure. Close. Close. I reduce. I suck. You see.
Okay.
You hold something.
Got resistance?
No.
But
niente.
I'm not so sure. One minute. It's okay. So at this stage, what do you think?
I think it looks good.
No, it does not look so good. No.
No.
I can clean that because I don't see the dots. Huh? The dots are around. You see?
Yeah, they're more laterally to this.
Mm. You see? No,
yeah.
It's not good. You see?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not surprised. So open. Abrir, por favor. You see?
Yeah.
It's not nicely done. Now, maybe, we do again. And then I step more at a distance to
so
better
much,
see. Okay? So I go back with the endoscope. Slowly like this.
Slowly.
Yes. Now you can close. And then if it does not work, we will... Yes, close.
Get a bigger one.
Yes. Now I push, I suck. I think it's...
That looks good.
It looks good, not perfect. No, it's exactly the same. Open. You see, things... If you want to be very, 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 very precise, you should... Okay, so I will do from this side, okay, from right part. Maybe it will be easier from the right part. I will try it again from this part. And if it does not work, I will reinject a little, or use a different snare.
You go to 15 millimeter. Perhaps.
Yes, but this you see, this is interesting. When you go laterally,
mm-hmm.
you better suck the lumen.
Yeah.
Yes, I better suck the lumen. Always, when you're in trouble, you go laterally and you better suck. And now you can close, maybe. Close. Yes. Close. Yes. Yes. Now.
No.
We were very, very close. Open again. Okay. We do again. So I go on the right. And now I suck again. Then I can suck because I'm not against the wall, so I can suck better. Okay. Now you close. But you close, huh? Close. Close more now. Close. Really more. No, it does not work. Open. So we will change the method. We will re-inject. This is interesting. I think at least I want to demonstrate that if you want to... That's why probably they were in trouble. Huh?
Mm-hmm.
If you want to be sure that you resect in one piece. Of course, another possibility could be to resect in several pieces.
You may want to consider to use the cap after all.
Yes.
To stabilize it in the distal rim of the cap.
Yes. This is the second option, to use the cap, but with some risk of perforation. So that's why I did not want to use the cap immediately.
Mm-hmm.
And also we can use a different...
Which kind of thing?
We can have a snare,
the
10 or 15 millimeter, but more a little more rigid if you have.
I have this kind of snare.
Yes?
If you use a
open.
Stiffer... Oh, are you changing the snare?
Yes.
For nitrile snare?
Inject. single wire.
Yes,
we will change the snare. But the ridge snare is more difficult to use when you are perpendicular. Yes, inject more, inject more.
Two.
Yes, inject more.
Five.
Yes, more.
Three.
Yes.
So
yes.
Luckily enough,
okay,
no sign
stop,
of
stop injection.
Nidaline.
No, okay. Show me this snare. This snare is 15?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, close.
That's a bit stiffer.
A bit that's stiffer.
There you go.
I use this snare. We change the snare, which is a monofilament snare. Huh? So a little more rigid. But nevertheless, it's a snare more difficult to use because it's more rigid. So when you are perpendicular, it's more difficult to make a curve with a loop. The snare, but we'll try again. Huh? Okay, now you open slowly. Oh, 1 minute. Open slowly. Open. Open. Okay. Slow. Stop. Stop. Open. Stop. You see, it's more difficult because open. Open. Yes. Open. Ah, 1 minute. Too rigid. Open more. Open, open, open. You're fully open? No. It's not. It's now it's now. Yes, now this is my fault because I did not push enough on the snare. So now
it's fully open.
Yes, but I'm not totally satisfied. At least initially the problem was at the upper part, was at the lower
Thierry,
part. So.
Thierry.
Yes, now it's a little better.
Some people continue to ask if we are sure that we are looking at the true duodenal bulb adenoma.
What?
Many people continue to ask if we are sure about the diagnosis.
Ask Lucio, huh?
you saw
my opinion, I 99% sure that it is the adenoma.
Yeah.
They perform biopsy. And at least biopsy. We have some histology and adenoma and low or high-grade dysplasia.
Yeah, with
and personally, macroscopically, yes, I think this is an adenoma. It is not an unequal metaplasia. It is not a Brunnerum. For sure, it is for me, it is an adenoma. The problem is that, I'm surprised that there is no scar.
Yeah.
But apart this fact, yes.
We did a very thorough inspection with the Indigo Carmen while we were offline.
Now you can close.
Yeah. Let's see.
Close. Yes. Close. Close. Close.
Okay, that looks pretty good.
Close better. Yes, it's a little better. So stop.
Okay.
Carla, come. No, let me see. We'll click. A sec. It's difficult to know if we take.
Well, I think you had a better grip on it on the distal part now, right?
Not totally sure, but okay, we will cut because we are losing our time.
And I think you had a little bit of margin where you put the.
Give me. Yes, I will cut. So for this, we have undercut two. Yes, we'll see. Yes, I push. Specimen out. Yes, it's a little to burn, but yes. It's burning, but at least you see here we are better. But at the upper part, I don't take my dots, so I'm a little unsatisfied.
So you would patch up the borders? But
okay, one first, nevertheless, is to take the specimen.
Because if you lose it, then the...
Yes. Oh.
There are two questions on the technique, band ligation and full thickness resection. Can you give a short comment whether this is also possible?
Say again, we didn't hear that question.
You have a trap?
Can you say that? Can you ask the question again, Amut?
What about band ligation or full thickness resection with Ovesco?
Yeah, I think you could do an FTDR here with if you have recurrent adenoma, especially if there would have been a scar without proper lifting. It's something you may want to consider. Although you should also be careful if you do that at this site that you don't grab the bile duct into your Ovesco clip. And in general, if you do the FTDR technique, the full thickness resection device technique, then it's advised to use the grasper instead of sucking in the lesion, because you never know what you're going to suck in. And there are actually some nice case reports already available now and videos showing that other structures are sucked into the cap. So I think it's safer to use them.
Thank you. I'm so sorry. We have to move for room B.
Okay.
Okay.
I will resect. I will. Okay. I think it's enough. Nevertheless, I'm not totally satisfied. I will see how the upper part lifts, and I will resect this part if I can. I will resect the upper part also. That means it will be a piecemeal resection, but it's better than nothing.